And welcome back to my channel, or of course welcome to my channel if you're new. If you are new, then hello, lovely to meet you. My name is Alex, and if you are new here, make sure you stick around and subscribe. If you're not new and you've been here for a while, then why not make sure that notification bell is switched on just so you're notified of every single time that I upload. Now for today's video, I have quite an exciting one because we are going to be testing out a brand new foundation from XX Revolution. This is called the Skin Light Compact Tinted Moisturiser. We are going to be doing a wear test in today's video. I know I haven't done one in a little while, but I thought because I have a combination skin type, I find these kinds of videos really helpful. So if you want to see how this applies, how it wears, what I think of it, then please keep watching. So if I look a bit red and flustered, I have just done a 20-minute cardio workout. Probably not the best thing to do before a foundation testing video, but I have cleaned my face. And I really needed to film this video, so let's get into it. For today's video, we are going to be testing a brand new XX Revolution foundation. This is the Skin Light Compact Tinted Moisturiser, and I got mine in the shade Light Neutral. This is what the packaging looks like. It is quite pretty packaging, actually. And this is also cruelty-free and vegan, and it costs £18. 1/8 for a cushion foundation. That is quite a lot. I did get it on a introductory offer of £13.50. Otherwise, to be honest, probably wouldn't have bought it. But this is what the packaging looks like. It has a really nice ribbed effect to it. The ribbed effect is on quite a lot of XX packaging, and I really like it. And it's quite a big compact, so it's quite a thick, bulky compact. But I think there is a light up mirror in here or something. So there's a little push button. You open it up, and this is what you get inside. As you can see, round the edges of the mirror, there is actually a light up feature in there, which is pretty unique. I don't think I've ever seen a cushion foundation have a light up mirror. Maybe that's why it costs £18, but would I prefer it not to have the light up feature for it to be a little bit cheaper? Absolutely. So at the top of the compact, you get a little pad, which you do see in a lot of cushion foundations, and it has XX on the little band there. And then you lift the flap, pull back this little bit of paper, and then we have the cushion foundation inside. So I'm just going to take this off. So this is what the cushion foundation looks like. As I said, I've got the shade Light Neutral, which I don't think is actually the lightest shade. And inside of here you get 15 grams of product for £18. I'm just going to throw on a primer because I always need to put primer before I put foundation on. I'll use an affordable one. This is the Makeup Obsession Picture Perfect Primer. This is so good if you like pore filling and things like that. This is a really good affordable primer. It's literally like £6 and it works amazing. It's a really good dupe of the Benefit Professional Primer. I am going to be doing a wear test for today's video, which is why I wanted to film it now. I'm actually filming this at 10 o'clock on Tuesday. So I wanted to put it on now, wear it for as long as possible, and update you throughout the day. Okay, so we're all primed. Now we can test out the foundation. So I'm actually going to use the little pad thing on one side, see if, you know, it makes a difference to application and things, and then I'll go in with a regular sponge on the other side because I don't think a brush would work with this kind of formula. I'm quickly just going to pull up the information. So online it says, our new lightweight natural skin tint is perfect for your no makeup makeup days. Its lighter finish is made for everyday wear and comes in 15 blendable shades with added lotus flower and cherry blossom extract to moisturise and soften skin and give you that natural soft blur focus finish. So I am expecting very light coverage. My skin at the moment is actually not that bad. I've got a few like blemish scarring at the moment, but I haven't actually got any like active acne. So I guess I'm just gonna push that in. And that is what Light Neutral is looking like. Okay, so I've put the foundation on one side of my face just to show you a comparison. So this side, my skin tone is definitely evened out. I had a lot of red blotchiness from where I did my workout, and I feel like it is really evened out my skin tone. The coverage is definitely light. You can definitely see blemishes still peeking through. So yes, very dewy, light coverage. Let's go in with a sponge on the other side and see if the sponge applies it any differently. That's the side with the sponge. I don't think there's much difference between the two sides, to be honest. I feel like it was quite easier to blend it out with a sponge on this side, so maybe I'll use this with a sponge from now on. I don't think the coverage is any different, so whether you use the pad in the compact or just a regular sponge, it's gonna be pretty much the same. The coverage is light. Again, you can see my blemishes and stuff peeking through, but it is still that really dewy finish. So this is what the foundation looks like applied. I am now going to hop off camera. I'm going to finish the rest of my makeup. I'm not doing much to my face today. I'm literally just going to do very bare minimum, a little bit of mascara, and that's it, because we're going to be doing a wear test for the rest of this video. I will come back when the rest of my makeup's on just to show you what my skin is looking like, and then we will begin the wear test part of this video. So right. Okay, so I've now got the rest of my makeup on. I've got the L'Oreal Infallible Concealer on, the I Heart Revolution Coconut Baking Powder, Revolution Pro Bahia Bronzer, the Sof Sugar Frosting Highlighter Duo, Dole Beauty Viva La Vacay Blush, P. Louise Blonde Blend Eyebrow Pencil, Collection Lash Surge Mascara, and finally the Sof Candy Icing Lip Balm. So this is my kind of natural makeup. So this could be someone's actual makeup routine, but this is quite natural for me. I've got no contour on or thick coverage or anything like that. So this is my natural makeup look for today. As for the foundation, like underneath all of this makeup, I think it actually went on fine. I don't have any particular dryness or anything like that. Of course, it is a dewy foundation, which I think you can still see on my forehead, but not super dewy looking. So even though it was really dewy going on, I think when I put the rest of my makeup on, it's kind of taken away a lot of that dewiness, which for me, with a combination skin type, is a good thing because I can get oily quite quickly. I think the coverage is a lot better as well now that I've put the rest of my makeup on. I would never just wear like a skin tint on its own. I'm just not like that. I would always put on like a little bit extra coverage and powder as well, because I know how oily I can get. So now we're gonna start the wear test part of this video. The time is currently 10:28 in the morning. I will try and keep this on as long as possible. The England game is on at 5 o'clock this evening, so depending on what my face is looking like, it might be finished then or after. I'm not really too sure. But now let's begin the wear test part of this video. Hello, it's me. It's literally been like 10 minutes, but I thought I'd just quickly note something. I just walked downstairs and the first thing my mum said to me was like, Alex, you literally look like you've got no foundation on right now. And to be honest, I kind of agree with her. Like, it doesn't look like I've got like a thick full coverage foundation on like I normally do. It does look quite natural. So if you're into your natural looking foundations, I think you are definitely going to like this. And also another thing to note is that it feels so incredibly lightweight. Like, I honestly cannot feel any makeup on my face right now. It feels so lightweight, not cakey, anything like that. It's definitely more of a natural foundation, so I'm definitely liking it so far. I just think it is quite expensive, and obviously we're gonna see how long it lasts, but yeah, I thought I'd just quickly do a very short check-in to let you know what my mum thought. Okay, so it's been a little while later. The current time is 14:50, so 10 to 3. I've had this on since about 10:30, 11:12, 1, 1:30, 2. So I've had this on for 4.5 hours, just under 4.5 hours. I have been at home, but I've also been out. I had a doctor's appointment, then I had to drop my brother off somewhere, so I have been out today. So I have worn a mask. I also popped into Hermes shop to drop some parcels off. So yeah, I have been out and about today. I have got a little bit of a mark here on my nose. I don't know if you can see that. And I'm also looking very oily. So as much as I love the application of this foundation, and that the fact that it like evens out my skin tone and things. This is not gonna last on me at all. Like, I'll probably do one more check-in and that'll be it, because I know what this is gonna look like in another couple of hours. If you've got an oily to combination skin type, this is not gonna last very long on you. As you can see, I've just taken my glasses off so you can see my face a little bit better, but obviously I'll have the little glasses mark either side here. But as you can see, under my eyes, forehead and chin, very oily. My nose is actually not too bad. I mean, it is a little bit oily, but it's not super, super oily. I'd say these areas are definitely the most oiliest. The thing is, right, as much as it doesn't last very long on my skin, if I just wanted something quick and easy to throw on just to even out my skin tone a bit, give me like the tiniest bit of coverage, and I was only out for a few hours, I'd definitely wear this again. I would not trust this if I was going out for a very long day out. It wouldn't last 3 hours on me, I don't think. But I would definitely wear this on days where I'm only popping out for a few hours and I just want a little bit of coverage. I love how lightweight it is. I love that it gives such a natural look to the skin. It doesn't even look like I'm wearing much foundation on my skin right now. So in terms of that, I'm actually really impressed with it. It's just the fact that it's just not going to last very long on my skin. I mean, even at 4.5 hours, I'm looking super, super oily. So yeah, it's not the most long-lasting product I've ever tried in my life, but I do actually love the formula of the foundation. I think it's really, really good. And if you do love these more lightweight, natural, light coverage foundations, then I definitely check this out. The fact that it's a cushion foundation is definitely different for me. It's not something that I reach for on a regular basis, but I'm just like looking in the little mirror here, like, because it's got little lights in it. So yeah, if you've got the same skin type as me, or an oily T-zone, oily skin type, you are not going to like this foundation. It's not going to last very long on you. But look at that. Oof. That is what you call a natural dewiness. It's oil. It's oil. So yeah, that is my little halfway check-in. I'll check in with you in literally a couple more hours and then I'll wrap up this video. Hi guys, so this is going to be my last check-in because the England game is literally in half an hour and I need to take this makeup off. So the time is 16:28, so this foundation has been on for 6 hours. Safe to say that my skin is looking very oily. It's probably going to just keep getting more oilier and oilier as the day goes on. But I pretty much rounded up all my thoughts in the last clip. This foundation is really pretty and I would definitely use it again, but only for when I'm, say, popping out for a few hours, not when I need a foundation to last all day. It is a very light to medium coverage, not coverage that I'm used to, but I kind of like the whole light coverage natural finish at the moment, especially when my skin is not too bad. So just to round up my thoughts on this foundation, it is very light coverage, a very natural looking foundation, not my normal type of foundation, but as I said earlier, I would definitely use this for when I'm going out for a few hours and just need a little bit of light coverage, not too much. I cannot wear this all day clearly because I'm just gonna just get really, really oily, which is a shame, but I wouldn't wear this type of foundation if I needed to wear foundation all day, if that makes sense. But overall, very pretty. It is expensive. I think it's still on the £13.50 offer at the minute. If it is, I would definitely recommend it to get it for a little bit cheaper. If it goes back up to £18, that is quite expensive. And if I can find a working Revolution code, I'll leave it down in the description box. So I'm going to wrap up this video here, guys. I really hope you enjoyed it. And if you did, please let me know by smashing the thumbs up button. Let me know down below, what do you think of this foundation? I'd love to know all your thoughts and opinions. And of course, if you haven't already, please subscribe down below and I will see you in my next video. Bye!